and to show you the latest results of this project. As the title says of this project, we developed a cell-based autonomous microsystem to sense the environment. The main scope is to really demonstrate an autonomous biosensor for environmental application, remote monitoring. So we will integrate a demonstrator. Basically, I will show you at the end, but that's what we have. This is the first demonstration. It's not yet so small, but it's thanks to your collaboration with the School of Applied Science in Sion. They have made that last night for us. It's functional, partly functional. But you will understand only at the end how it works. We also, within this project, not only have the objective to make a demonstrator, but we really want to study the various cell models for the best assay for toxicology in general, and also for not only for the environment, also to develop new physical methods, because if you have a cell-based sensor, what is essential is if your cells are modified by the toxicants, you should measure something out of these cells. That's not the easiest part. And finally, if we want to maintain these cells inside this nice box, we need to create a micro bioreactor, and there are a lot of also essential scientific challenges there. We are a good team of groups, ranging from microbiology group, like at university, biophysics, biology group, also chemistry, microfluidics, and the system integrators. Why do we want to make cell-based sensors? The cell-based biosensor, the main advantage is that they provide, in principle, they should provide a biologically relevant information. If you screen for compounds, pollutants by analytical chemistry, you will have first to know a priori what is your compound and what you have to be to have listed your compounds. But of course, this advantage may become also a disadvantage. You're not very specific, but you just screen for, if you screen for toxicology, you hope that it's relevant for the human toxicology. It can be extremely sensitive. There are some cells, and I will show you, for instance, with the bacterial cells, they can detect pollutants or toxic levels that are smaller than what you can get with very expensive analytical instruments. And of course, here in this project, we take opportunity of the Nano-Tera to have this application to monitor the environment, but there is a big need in toxicology screening in general in the lab, and we want to screen, you know, there is a need to screen all the new chemicals that are produced, to also test the food, and the cells for that are very good systems. So what did we choose in this project? We would like to use mammalian cells, because these mammalian cells are closer physiologically to the human cells, so and of course if we test for the toxicity, it would be good to test with relevant cells. And of course, they are, as I said before, non-specific to detection. The problem is that they need really strict incubation conditions, and the advantage is that they are already known in toxicology. In drugs, toxicology, it's routinely used, and people use sophisticated readouts for that, but it's known in incubators. So the challenges there are to find the detection methods, to make the bioreactors, and so on. I will come back later with that. University of Applied Science in Sion, in the group of Marcel Geyser, they have developed a compact fluorescence meter and that is combined with the microfluidics. And this is what you have on the table here, and you see that it's for the moment it's rather big, and we make it with stacks because it's easy to exchange to optimize. There is one microfluidic layer, the layer for the fluorescent sensor, the layer for the data processing, power supply, and some micro pump for perfusion. So now, here what you have on the table is the demonstrator, and what I have in my hand is a Nokia phone, it's not an iPhone for my time. And now, as it is now with the demonstrator, I can call there is no sound, unfortunately. But I'm calling now the system here. It's going to, after three calls, the system is going to turn on. And it means start the measurements. And then when the measurement is starting, there is a pump. There's maybe some light blinking there. And then after a certain time of incubation, it is reading the fluorescence of the bacterial sample, and it will send me back. Now it's too late, but in maybe 20 minutes or 10 minutes, will send me back an SMS with the fluorescence level. So this is the first demonstration. Next year, I will come with a much more sophisticated demonstrator. So we send the SMS, start the perfusion, make a reference measurement, incubate the cells, so with the micropumps here, then make the measurements after a while, send back an SMS, and I have my information. And this could be placed everywhere, anywhere in the world, provided that you give him a battery and you load with the cells, of course. And I don't want to hide some remaining challenges there. So with that, I terminate my talk. Thank you for your attention.